One of these days, you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that. Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything.
So what's the big crisis this time? New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon. Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute, because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there, as soon as you're ready. Side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
We got what we needed. The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out.
Yes. Their greatest secret has finally been revealed. But that only leads to more questions. How does it work? Where do we go next?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
Why? What makes the glowing sea so dangerous?
The name says it all. Radiation. So much that nothing there could possibly live. Nothing pleasant. Navigating radioactive hazards is nothing new. But the glowing sea can kill a man in seconds. That's why it doesn't make sense. Virgil fleeing into that hell. The exposure alone.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield, or a cloak. A way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same. If you're going to follow him.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Radex, Radaway. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs. Memory Den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. I was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You feeling all right, Nick?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Amari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
We have to head into the glowing sea. Any advice?
I'm a synth, so radiation isn't much of an issue for me, but an old suit of power armor might just be the guardian angel you're looking for. That, or you could buy up all the Radex and Radaway you can find from any chem dealer who's got it in stock.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next.
everyone, gather around. Let's keep the breeze back. Shoot the fat. Now, I know y'all are doing your own thing, but I don't want anyone here to forget what matters. Hey, Daisy, glad you can make it. How's my favorite girl?
Happy Halloween.
You scared?
This is the other day.
Forever. At least, not if I have my say.
Hey, Piper.
Head my way?
You know what? Never mind.
You know where to find me.
Inside, you got,
junk in here.
the airport, huh? You sure you want to walk through Brotherhood HQ with
this
a tank at your side?
Civilians. I order you to stand down and tell me what you're doing here immediately.
On whose authority?
By the authority of Elder Arthur Maxon, Supreme Commander of the Brotherhood of Steel. Now I'll repeat my question. What are you doing here?
I was hoping to track down the owners of that huge airship.
Well, you found us. And since this is a military installation, this is the closest you're going to get to her.
I understand. I'm ex-military myself.
Really? Well, then you might just be in luck. With your experience, you might actually fit in with the Brotherhood. We're always looking to add a few more brothers and sisters to our ranks, if you think you have what it takes.
Absolutely. I'm in.
Well, all right. Glad to have you aboard. Head over to the Cambridge Police Station and look for Paladin Dance. He's in charge of our new recruits, and I'm certain he'll be glad to have an extra gun on his team. Ad Victoriam, civilian. And good luck.